It's finally happening. So hi y'all, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, this is me, Sonika, and we're going to be doing a review today. And this is one of the most exciting launches and in my opinion, like the most needed launch. And this has just been like waited for like years and years and years by me. And I've just been looking for good products in the drugstore market in this category. So we're going to be talking about the Sugar Blend Trend brushes, and I have all 13 of them here. So quickly, without any further ado, let's just get started ahead with the review. So if you know me, that I look for really good quality, and I literally am very brutal with my reviews. So we're just going to be testing every single product, and I have been using them for about 2 weeks continuously on a day-to-day basis just to see how they work and how they function. So let me just break down the packaging. When I first received it, I received this in a kit like this. So you can just like, you know, just put your brushes in here and you can just dump some of your makeup in here and you're done. So this is kind of removable. So you can take the pouch off separately in case you are doing like client makeup or something. You can just take the brush belt and go, and it just folds in a lot more easier. So these do not come together in a set, and these can be bought individually, and I'll leave all the links for the brushes down in the description bar below along with the prices. So they basically launched two different types of brushes. One is like the basic kind of brush where you just have the bristles on one side, you have a metallic ferrule and, you know, kind of like a wooden handle in the bottom, and the other one is basically dual ended. So you do have like two different applications brushes together in one brush. So all of the brushes in this range are synthetic, and they kind of have a very duo fiber kind of an effect, and they are extremely soft. I used a couple of brushes even for smudging my kajal and all that stuff. So I would say that these are extremely soft. I did not feel anything prickly, anything like that going on. So these are extremely good quality. They did not shed when I washed them too, which was a great thing. I didn't wash all of the brushes. I washed about two of the eye brushes just to see how they wash, and I didn't have anything tearing off or anything getting rough or any of the bristles falling off. So that was a great thing about these. So when you look at the handle is basically wooden and the ferrule part is metal, and the bristles are basically synthetic, and these are extremely soft. They kind of remind me of Real Techniques brushes. So when you look at Real Techniques brushes, if you have them, and when you feel your Real Techniques brushes, this is kind of very similar to how that one feels. Or maybe I would even say that it's a bit more softer than the Real Technique ones. So another thing which was quite shocking for me, and I was yet so amazed about it, is that every single brush has a brush protector with it. So when it comes to the eye brushes, which are a lot more smaller, they had ones like these, and for the double ended ones, they had ones like these, and for, you know, like for the face brushes and all this stuff, they had this net kind of one. And in my opinion, I've received a lot of brushes like Sigma brushes, MAC brushes, PAC brushes, so many. Like I've tried so many brands and so many brushes from now, both national and international, and sometimes there are certain brushes where they do not have the brush protectors, and sometimes they just don't fit, they just don't work, they just kind of look like they've put it for just for the sake of putting it. So that did not happen with these brushes, and every single one of these can be used, and these are very helpful, especially when it comes to travel. So we're going to move on to a very detailed review of each and every single brush, including application and including what are my own opinions about it and how it's made and all that stuff. So let's start off. So in order of application, the first one I'm going to talk about is the flat foundation brush, which is 051. So when you look at this brush, I think when it comes to sizing wise, it's perfect, and it's really stiff. One of the most biggest problem with a lot of drugstore brands or with a lot of inexpensive brushes is that they make very flimsy brushes. So they would move a lot, and it just goes everywhere, which would not pick your makeup, and nor does it really deposit it on your face. So it's basically a dud. So that did not happen with this brush. I really like the way it moves. It has a bit of movement, but at the same time, it's really stiff. So when you see, can you see the brush is not poking? Do not do this on your face, but this is just a way for you to know that the brush is really dense. So I think overall, this is a great brush. And if you're looking for a flat foundation brush, this is a big thumbs up from my side. So moving on to the next brush, which is kind of a staple in, you know, your everyday makeup routine, which is your foundation brush 052, which is a kabuki brush. So when you look at this brush, and you can check that in the close-up, so it's extremely soft and it barely has a lot of movement. So when you look at the brush, it's very densely packed and it does not really bend when you're doing your foundation. So it's great to kind of buff your foundation into your skin, which is a great thing. And I would definitely say that this one works as good as my Sigma brushes and my Zoeva brushes. So, and also another thing is that the length of the brush is like really well thought of, and sometimes brands just go wrong by making it too long and it just kind of like drags all of your face. So that did not happen with this. And so it's not too stiff, it's not too soft, it's kind of somewhere in the middle, and it's really dense, and I would definitely say this is a must buy from this entire brush range. So moving on, we're going to speak about the powder brush, which is 007. And when you look at this brush, I would say that this is like a classic powder brush which a lot of people use. So if you're someone who's looking for a very big powder brush just to, you know, kind of set your entire face, I think this would be great. But I have oily skin and I like to selectively apply my powder. So I like to take it all the way till the inner corner and kind of just apply it. So this is a little too big, or I may say very big for my face, and I do have a big face. So this one really does not fit really well, and you can see the demo, I'm kind of struggling to do my powder with this brush. So it does not get into the nooks and crannies and all that, but I think this would be great for, you know, doing your bronzer, you know, just like an overall bronzer, and you know, just for like if you have really huge cheek, this would work really good on your cheek too. But for powder, I think this is a big, like I would definitely not recommend this for powder. So moving on to the next brush, we're going to talk about the contour brush 003. So when I first received this brush and when I was kind of like playing around with it, like I noticed that it's really not dense and it moves a lot. So when it comes to cream contouring, and if you have a pan of product and if you dip it inside and then if you go into your skin and if you just kind of like blend it and apply it, then at that point of time it does blend beautifully. It does not really have any tuggingness, and because the brush really moves so much, it doesn't drag any of the product underneath, which is your foundation. But if you have something like a cream contour stick and then if you start going on your face and then if you try to buff it out, it becomes really hard because this one isn't dense enough to move all that product, so it just leaves you with a couple of streak marks and, you know, with a couple of patches. Moving on to the next brush is the blush brush, and this is basically 001. So one thing about the blush brush is that it's quite small compared to what a lot of us use, but I think this works really good for a very precise blush application. If you're someone who doesn't want to get pink all over your face, I think this is great for that. And one amazing thing is that this one works for creams as well as powders. So if you're someone who's looking for a blush brush which isn't too big, and if you want to kind of precisely apply and place your product, I think this is a great one to go in for. So for beginners, I wouldn't recommend this, but if you're somewhere in the intermediate side and if you have a lot of other blush brushes which do not really work for you, and if you're looking for something a lot more smaller and you're looking for something for your cream blushes, I think this is the best one to go in for. So moving on to the next brush, which is the highlighter brush, and this is basically 006. So I'm so glad that there's a brand which has kind of made a very sensible highlighter brush, which is not a fan brush. So when it comes to me, you will never see me using a fan brush for highlighter. I hate fan brushes for highlighter. So I love something where you can just take it and place it correctly. So this is a great one. And when you see my usual highlighter brush, these are like extremely similar. So I love the fact that this one really works, and this one does the work of highlighting your face. And this is really so small that you can even take it on the bridge of your nose without making it too thick, and it works really good on your cupid's bow, your eyebrow and above your eyebrow and your cheek and all that. So I think this is a great one. And so this one will work even for your under eye concealer. If you just want to slightly just blend it out, this will be great for that. If you want to set your under eye concealer with a little bit of powder, great brush. If you want to contour your nose, great brush. I think overall, I think this is a great one, and this is a big thumbs up from my side. So now that we've completed the entire face, we're going to move on to the eyes, and this is the first brush, which is the concealer brush 002. So when you look at this, this is basically a flat concealer brush, and this one works really good for doing your under eye concealer. The only thing about this brush is that if you're a beginner and if you press too much on your skin when you're doing your concealer, you're going to kind of move your concealer everywhere and you're going to end up with a very streaky concealer application. So but if you're someone who kind of, you kind of know your way around products, and if you're kind of used to having a very light hand with your brushes, this is great for your concealer. So when you see the brush, it's quite stiff, but it has a bit of bend with it. It's not as stiff as the foundation brush, so this one works really good for that. It works really good to carve out your eyebrows, and I tried it for a cut crease. It does help with the cut crease, but not too precise. I'll show you another brush which works better for a cut crease than this one. So for my usage and for my application, I think this brush works works perfectly. So we're going to move on to the eye brushes, and the first one is the flat eyeshadow brush 041. So when you look at this one, this is a great one for doing your cut crease. So I'm just going to insert a picture of this brush, the concealer brush and the foundation brush, so you can see the size different between each of them. If your eyeshadow is not very pigmented, this wouldn't help to take the product on your brush. But if you have like a very shimmery highlighter, or if you're going to use it for glitters, I think this will work really well. So the thing with this brush is that it's a little too stiff and it doesn't have any movement to take the product in it to apply it on your eye. So with shimmers, I think this wouldn't be a good brush for doing it. But for other applications like doing your cut crease and all that stuff, this is amazing. So moving on to your next brush, which is a blending brush, which is called as the round eyeshadow brush, which is 042. So when you see this one, this is basically a crease blending brush and it works really good even in your lower lash line. So if you want something very, very with high precision, this wouldn't work. But if you're someone who just wants to take the product into your crease and you want to blend it, I think this is great for it. I have hooded eyes and this one fits really well into my eye and it isn't too big. So it does pick product really well and it also works really good with blending in a very precise manner. So it doesn't go everywhere on your face, which is a great thing with this brush. So we're going to move on to the next one, which is the round XL brush, which is basically like your transition eyeshadow brush. So when you see this brush, this one does not really move a lot like how much it should move for a transition brush. So it is a little difficult to blend out that outermost color when you're using this brush. Rather, I would say this one works good for something which is like a crease to a transition brush, but like beyond transition to the skin, it might be a little difficult to use this one. But if you're someone who has like really small eyes, and I think this would work great for that. These two brushes, the previous one and this one, will work great for cream products. But with powder products, it has a little bit of a drag. It does not blend freely, even with like the most slightest pressure from my hand without me bending the bristles. It doesn't move as freely as my regular brushes do. I'm gonna leave a small insert of these two brushes just for a size comparison of it. So we've spoken about the 10 brushes which are like the single side brushed ones, and we're going to speak about the dual ones. So the first one is 075, that is powder plus foundation brush, and the second one is 413, which is a flat plus round XL brush, and then we have 412, which is a flat plus round brush. Just a couple of things that I wish that they would add on would be, first, a lip brush. They did not have a lip brush in this range. And secondly, a pencil brush, you know, just something a lot more smaller and a lot more detailed for doing a little bit of eyeshadow work would be great. So the third brush they would launch would be an eyebrow brush and then an eyeliner brush, or they can kind of combine it together and have an angled liner brush. So I did post a try on and the review of the newly launched Sugar Good Moody's lipstick probably like a week before, so make sure you check that one out too. I'm gonna drop the link down in my description bar below. So if you like this video, do give me a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It took me a lot of time, a lot of planning and a lot of effort to do this, so I just hope that you guys just let me know your feedback on what you thought about this video down in the comment section below, and I'll catch up with you guys for another one. Until next time, bye.